pre-workout Pop-Tart. Pop-Tart pump. And we have shoulders today. So, we're going to film it. I'm going to try to talk about it, whatever I'm doing, and then go from there.
What's up? Be my booty walk. I'm just kidding. Don't do that. YouTube. Okay. Not very good at it. What? Getting used to like talking on the thing.
You look cute. You.
Stephanie, say hi to YouTube.
YouTube.
All right, babe, that's enough. Good Lord. I'm like, stop. You're killing me. Like, give me moments like where you're not filming. Hey girl, how are you? Hey. Shut up. Go kill it, girlfriend. You're gonna work out too, though, right?
Yeah. Can I talk about why you're stretching?
I am stretching because my neck and my shoulders feel tight. And I got shoulders, so I want to make sure I'm warmed up pretty good. To prevent injury. Yeah. I will admit that I think I hurt myself because I was getting a little lax with my stretching and with my, yeah. So don't do that, guys. Very important. Shut up. Straight arm pull down and shoulder plate warm up. So we'll go warm up shoulders and then get to it. I love this song because it's about like becoming better. Whoa, still warming up. Lateral raises.
What's next?
Lateral with a plate. Wow, my brain just went blank. Oh, yes, this song is nice too. Had to get my handy dandy tools for the gym. Gaspari. Better Bodies Ambassador.
What's the significance of having wraps?
Well, for me, I like get real weak real quick. So I feel like they help me stabilize my wrists. So I'm not like this or like that. Just saying. That's just my personal preference. I'm not here trying to tell nobody how to do nothing. You do what works for you. It's a plate warm up, so still just warming up. Ooh, gems are on fire today. Way to go, Rockbot. Great. Front raises and then shoulder press. Make sure. Yep.
What first?
Dumbbell shoulder raises. I like these. Week today. Okay guys, so there's no rhyme or rhythm to my YouTube videos right now. One day soon I will get there, but right now it's just gonna be like me getting into the hang of things. So that being said, I do wanna give a little bit of a competition slash prep update. I'm currently in off season. I know I mentioned that I'm working with Olivia GravenGaard. She's been great. She helped me 8 weeks out through my last show. And I absolutely love working with her. So make sure you guys check her out. I'll put her here on the, like, somewhere right here. And then, yeah, so what I'm saying, I guess, is that right now I'm in my off season. I'm eating a lot of food. My carbs are high. My fats are high. My protein's high. Things that I've kind of dealt with going through my off season is, you know, digestion starts to slow, start to get really full, obviously. And so we've been tackling, you know, left and right, little things like that. So,
how is off-season mentally?
Off-season is definitely a lot harder than prep. Because body composition gets up there. You're pushing a lot heavier weight. You're eating a lot more. So you're just kind of uncomfortable. A different kind of uncomfortable. I'm not sure if it's because I'm used to prep or what, but like, man, off season, it's just completely different ball game. It's, you know, constantly fighting of eating what food you want versus the foods you need to eat to perform well. So I'm getting better, but I'm working on it for sure. So I'll get to show that with, you know, in my later videos of how that, you know, food is going and stuff like that. So, but I will say right now my weight is 124. Somehow I lost a pound since the other day. So I'm actually kind of nervous because I don't know if that means I'm losing muscle mass or what that might mean, but we'll take it as it comes and take it day by day. So we got a shoulder press next. All right, so I'm gonna do a couple of warm-up sets and then I'll get into my working sets. Calling me baby. Say my name, say my name. Shade ain't calling me baby. Who you with? I came over with my clique. Gotta bounce, it's 3 seconds ago. Since just got in the house. To believe that you are sometimes I just don't even count. I just go for when I feel it. same one.
I'm gonna keep it there. We're gonna need that. We're gonna need Smith shoulder press. We're gonna need an incline bench and go to the Smith machine. I just put something in my cup.
Back. Somebody's on there. Let's adapt. Shit, that sucks. Machine lateral raise. Oh, perfect. How convenient.
So this here would be a Arsenal Strength machine lateral raise. It is not my favorite, but I make it work. Hey, can I do like a tip really quick? So I see a bunch of girls grab these things and they're like.
How was that?
And I'm not making fun of anyone. This is just a straight up tip. Get your arms to where you're gonna actually feel it in that muscle. So I put my wrist here and I kind of just guide the little bars and I stick my elbows out. So that way when I come up, I'm feeling it right in my delts, right in there. Versus here where I feel like I'm turning my arms out, my wrists are let go. Just don't do that. Just feel it. By number five, I'm already burning. Okay, no more. Started to feel my traps take it a little bit. Round two. Take two. See my. Pretty proud that I can see that still in off season. It's been a while since I've been able to do that. So, this is the substitution for Smith shoulder press. Supposed to do two sets, 10 to 12. So, I did my warm up set. Now, I'm going to actually do my two working sets. So, I might try to add weight. And then once we get done with that, then we're supersetting lateral raises with an AMRAP and tricep cable pushdowns, which everyone knows I hate triceps, but we will do it. We will make these baby horseshoes something today. Wait, I feel really low. Excuse me. Do you want more? So something I do that helps me with heavy lifts is I kind of brace myself. So this is technically not that heavy, but it helps. I'm gonna go ahead and do my second set too.
feet don't reach the ground. Short girl problems. Okay, so next we got machine lateral raises, but I actually think I'm gonna switch it out for plate lateral raises, just because we just did machine lateral raises. And we're gonna superset it with tricep cable pushdowns. So we're gonna take it over there so that way I can watch myself, really fully feel the contraction, and work these horseshoes. All right, so I'm gonna go a little light, so that way I can get as many reps as possible. So I could totally feel my left arm fatiguing faster than my right arm. I was like, second set, yeah, last set. So I've noticed that if I really like turn, I feel it more like deep in my tricep. I'll fill those tomorrow. Fatigue. All right, partials. When I start to notice my body fatigue, that's when I stop. If I start doing things and I feel other muscles pulling, not the muscle I'm trying to target, that's when I'm like, all right, either partials or everything, it's over. It's all I can get. It's all I can get for that muscle group. So that was my failure. Okay, so this is the last exercise listed on my workout program for today. I'm excited because I'm getting real sweaty and my hair is sticking to my back. It's gross. I'm assuming that we are just going for lots of blood into the shoulders. So I got 15 to 20 reps of lateral band raises. And I'm on number 3 and I already feel it. I went with a pretty skinny band, not too skinny, but pretty skinny, so that way I had good resistance. What number is that?
How does the band differ from weight?
Constant tension. So low key, really excited we substituted that other workout because that person's still on the Smith machine. All right. So another reason why I use a band, or why you could use a band, is it adds variety to your workout, and it also keeps constant tension on the muscle, which I definitely am feeling right now. So add it to the beginning of your workout for a warm up, to get things moving, get blood flowing, or you can use it at the end of your workout to really make sure that you hit that muscle group to the best of your ability for that specific arm day or muscle group day. Woo! Definitely gets the heart rate going too. Make sure you hold it up and go slow on the down. Don't just like all right, that's my workout, guys. All right, guys, so that was my shoulder workout. I hope you guys really like the footage. I plan on doing a lot more exercise videos just because they're fun for me and I really enjoy sharing the workouts. But please comment below. Give me some ideas of what you guys want to see, whether it's training, food, life, business. Other than that, I will catch you guys on the next one. I don't know what I was doing.